ever since I recorded this short clip that uses shapes on Photopea, I've received numerous requests to create a long video. So let's create a long video with three options. Let's learn the first technique of creating shapes and then creating an extra gap to create a design. We're going to go to shapes and select the ellipse shape. And we're going to go to color, and we're not going to have a filling on this shape. With our stroke, we're going to pick a nice gold yellow, and we just want the pixels to be maybe 4 or 3, not that much. And using your ellipse tool, if you hold your shift up on a Mac, you get a perfect circle. If you just wing it without holding the shift key, it's shift on Windows and it's a arrow up on a Mac, then you can make a shape the way that you want. So create a circle, and then holding your alt key with your move tool, you can always use a V to select the move tool. Holding your alt key, then you're going to duplicate this shape to have a second round shape. With our move, we can select all of the layers and we can move the layers if they're all grouped together. If you want to make them bigger, you can switch on the transform tool to just make them a little bit bigger. And then if we're happy, we click on correct and we tick. If I then wanted to create a gap, maybe I want to add a name of a business on here, then I'm going to go and select either the rectangle select or the ellipse select. It depends which one you want to use. So say for instance, we want to use the rectangle select. Then I'm going to create a gap on here. Once I've selected it and I've made sure that the layer is selected, then I press back arrow. I go to my next layer, again the back arrow, and I go to the last layer, again back arrow. Then I have a gap and I can do whatever I want with the design. That's the first way that I want to show you. Manipulate shapes on Photopea is using the ellipse tool. So you're going to select your ellipse tool and you're going to pick a color that you want to use, and then you're going to create a round shape. As easy as that, you're then going to press V or select the move tool, hold the alt key, and then create a second shape. Switch on the control tools so that you can see what you're doing. Reduce the size of the second shape and then align it on top of the first shape. Then you're going to go to your layers and you're going to go to combine shapes and you're going to subtract. And you have a beautiful moon shape that you've created. Same principle, you're going to go back to your ellipse tool and create a second round shape, and you want a different color this time, and you're going to use your move tool, and you're going to hold the alt key, create a second shape, reduce that, align it on the first shape, and then go to your layers and then click on combine shape, and then you can subtract. So these tools are also available, the unite, the intersect, and exclude, that you can also use when you are designing. So with your exclusion, we've excluded a little bit and we have extra that's left on there. So I want to use the subtract, so I'm going to undo and then I'm going to combine and subtract. As easy as that, that's how you use your subtract to create beautiful designs on Photopea. Let's jump in on the third one that I absolutely love. With the last way of using your shape, you want to customize your own shapes. And it is the most favorite way of doing this. You're going to go to where shapes are, the shapes tool, and you're going to select custom shapes. With the custom shapes, it's going to show you that it has selected a star shape. But do you necessarily want a star shape? Not necessarily. Therefore, you're going to go to shapes, the drop down arrow on there, and you're going to wait for Photopea to load different kinds of custom shapes that you could use. And it goes from alphabets, animals, and so forth. You could also type what you're looking for and find it. So I'm looking for a teardrop and I don't find it that way. So I'm going to scroll down until I find this teardrop that I want to use for my design. It's on shapes folder. So if I select this shape, it gives an option to say that you've selected that shape over there. And when you access your canvas and you click and you hold, it starts creating the shape that you've selected. And it is a fill. So I don't want to have it filled. I'm going to have no fill, and I want the color to be a nice bright pink. And I'm going to draw my shape. Lovely. Then I'm going to use my move tool, and I want to rotate this shape and have it point upwards. And then I'm happy with the correct mark. Holding my alt key, I'm going to duplicate this shape to have a second shape. And I'm going to keep on doing this until I have 9 shapes that are going to create this Zen flower that I want to create. Michael J. Wynn, no, I'm not a robot, I'm in my own skin. Never get lost when thoughts pull you in. I miss the old you. We died with a purpose. All the energy around me felt nervous. Scared I would pop out fast to the surface. Had to cut it off before you made me worthless. Torn apart, I've been torn and scarred. I had a given art, but now I'm thinking smart. I'm keeping up my guard. I'm hiding every card. A royal flush of love. You never know what's hard. With a back to the mat, gonna see where I'm at. I'm a fight like I'm mad. I'm a beast. Something that they can never be. There's your Zen flower. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial of shapes on Photopea. If you want to learn more on Photopea, we do have a playlist that you can access. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on the next video.